Hi everyone, in this video we are going to see about Nifty breakout levels and some quick market updates also. By watching this video you can gain some knowledge about the market and what are the steps you need to take on Monday also we will tell you. Those who are new to channel, kindly subscribe the channel and select the ring bell. By selecting the ring bell you will get the notifications of my videos continuously. If you watch it you will be updated on the market also. If you feel like the video kindly select the like button and share it. By selecting the name of this channel, NSC Commodity Trader, you will go to the home page. In home page, you can see more strategy videos, indicator videos in both Tamil and English language. By watching this, you can gain some knowledge about market also. We are also providing levels for commodity and we are also taking more advanced trading strategy also. If you want to know about these details means, you can WhatsApp or contact my number in the below of the video. And if you want to open a DMAT or trading account, you can contact my number or select the link in the video also. If you select the below link also means the account opening process will get start. Nifty. On Friday, Nifty ended up as a bearish candle. On first day of this year also a bearish candle. And then the first week of this year also a bearish candle. But market was on positive side only, market was on peak only, but why it ended up as a bearish candle? Why market fall on Friday? If you feel like if you have those question means, if you take a look at technical wise means, the market is already on the peak. It is up to the 12,290 range. The first time a doji candle has been formed at the high of 12,290. After a doji candle has been formed in this high, previous week also we said if market didn't break out this 290 we cannot see any new high in the market. So those things happened repeatedly this week also. Previous week also market tried to break out this 290 level but it didn't break. This week also on Thursday it came up to 12,290 but it didn't break the 290 range. So market is having a strong resistance on 12,300 according to technical wise. Okay, what happened? What are the fundamental reasons that pulled down the market with the gap down also? Let's take a look. On Friday, before market opened, US military attacked on Iran commander Qasem Soleimani. He is a famous commander for Iran military. After his attack, what happened means the crude oil price started to rise. If crude oil price started to rise means that will suffer Indian economy, like there are so many in Middle East also has been tension has been fallen due to the tension around the global market. Our market also has been started to fall. So this is the fundamental news that affected our Nifty also. Many of them will have doubt why if a crude oil price started to rise means what will affect for us means. If crude oil price started to affect means the petrol price will get increased. The petrol price will get increased means that will affect our food price also will get increased. If our every daily day routine process, daily day routine products price also will get increased. If that happened means the inflation price will get increased. So overall the inflation will get affected if crude oil price started to spike means. Due to that only our economy has been fallen. And if you take a look at fundamentally means after opened also crude oil has been spiked in upside only. So due to that our market also started to fall. And then the one major thing has been happened, that is dollar. Dollar price has been spiked 40 paise against our INR. So our INR has been pulled down by 40 paisa. And it will be like a huge effort for us. Currently trading at near to 72 rupees USD versus INR. So this is bad news for us. So due to that also our setter has been fallen. If you take a look at setter wise means, let's take a look at sector also. In sector wise the major effect has been happened in Nifty Bank due to the INR price has been fallen. If Nifty Bank fallen means the next one is Nifty PSU Bank and then the continuation of Nifty Private Bank also. If our financial sector has been pulled down means then the auto sector, metal sector also got affected. Due to these things fallen so the Nifty sector has been pulled out very well. And then the separate thing there is one Nifty Media. Nifty Media also affected 2% because of the Troy's controlling those channels prices. Due to that Nifty Media also affected. And if you take a look at particular stock G Media means it has been fallen more on the Friday also. That is the Nifty top loser on Friday. Let's come back to Nifty. Nifty, these are the fundamental thing and technical thing that has been happened in the Nifty. Let's take a look at what will happen on Monday, what we can expect on Monday. Monday also, you can see, let's take a look at breakout levels. Where market is opening, that is what is the important key in the current market. So according to my vision, if market opened below 12,200 means, and after that below open, if market crosses this 12,200 range means, we can expect some positiveness in the market. We can see some recovery in the market. But if market didn't break out 12,200 range means, then it is going to be a falling market. It is going to be a bearish market. You can expect some short term bearish, like another 100 point falling in the market also. For intraday also, it will fall. The first level support will get breakout. So due to that, the first level support, if flip over range, we can say 12,200. The next level major support is 12,150. As you can see previously, 12,150, whenever market touches, it will start to recover. If that 150 range also got breakout, means the market will move down to 12,100. That is the next level huge support. So these are the supportive levels for Nifty. Whenever a breakout happen, you can expect some downside in the continuously. So on Monday, we are expecting some bearish trend in the market. If a gap down has been acquired, means we can see some recover. If market opened near to 12,220 range means, that means it is going to be a bearish market only, because market cannot able to recover that much quickly. If it opened near 12,220 range means, you need to be cautious. It is going to be a bearish market. After the crossover has been 12,200 means, you can expect another 40 point in the downside. If suppose market opened at gap down of 12,200, then it crosses 12,200, it crosses above 12,200 means, you can expect some recovery in the market. So these are the trading method, and these are the levels you can go for it. So watch out for this, where is the opening is happening. According to the opening only, you are going to make the decision. If it opened above 12,200 means, you can go for selling in the market. If it opened below 12,200 means, you need to watch out for the levels, because if it crosses 12,200 after the gap down means, you can expect some positiveness in the market. Like there will be a small recovery up to 12,240 range, like that. The major resistance is seen at 12,250, and then the huge resistance is seen at 12,300. So these are the hugest resistance for Nifty according to current level. Okay. We are also taking more advanced trading strategy class. If you want to know about it, you can WhatsApp or contact my number. And we are also providing levels for commodity also, crude oil, copper, zinc and gold, like that. We will provide levels in the morning itself. If you want to know about these details means, you can WhatsApp or contact me. If you want to open a DMAT or trading account, kindly select the link in below description, below of the video. The account opening process will get start. Or you can just contact me. I will guide you for account opening. In future, if you want to see more videos like this means, kindly subscribe my channel and select the ring bell. By selecting the ring bell, you will get the video notifications. By watching the video, you will be updated on the market also. Thank you.